In this video, I'm going to show you how to improve your YouTube SEO by tracking your rankings in YouTube. So as you know, there are already a million and one rank trackers for Google, but there aren't that many for YouTube that are reliable. And actually, if you're invested in YouTube SEO and you want to succeed with it, it's important, just like with Google, to track your rankings. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. So your first step is to determine which keywords you want to rank for. Just like with Google, it is important to have a target keyword for pretty much every video you put out there. It's totally okay to occasionally just put out some videos that, you know, aren't necessarily designed to rank in YouTube. Just like with your content marketing, you will occasionally put out maybe an industry study or an editorial piece or something controversial, not necessarily meant to rank in Google, but just meant to bring in traffic through other ways. And that's totally fine. But what you want to do is for your YouTube videos that you actually want to rank, identify the target keyword for each of those videos. So in this case, it would obviously be Kyle's video about on-page SEO. And then what you want to do is head over to the rank tracker for YouTube. And when you enter your channel, you'll be prompted to enter those keywords. Just like with any rank tracker, it'll go out and it'll look for your rankings for those different keywords, along with your average ranking, keyword distribution, and then rankings over time. So in this case, I wouldn't sweat keyword distribution too much. Obviously, you want to rank in the top three for most of them, but really you want to look at individual videos and see what you can learn about why they're doing well or why they're not doing well and what your competitors are doing that you can learn from. So let's look at a quick example here for this piece about B2B content marketing that recently shot up in the rankings, this video by Ross Simmons. So cool feature of this tool is that you can actually look at the SERPs without needing to go to YouTube. And you'll notice sometimes, you know, the videos that rank higher in YouTube aren't necessarily those with the most views. That's because YouTube, just like Google, is trying to show someone the best result for that search. And in the case of B2B content marketing, Semrush obviously does a good job of describing what B2B content marketing is and some things that you can actionably do. And that's probably the search intent for this keyword versus this video from Gary Vee, which might be good for someone browsing YouTube. That's why it has so many views, but it might not be something that matches with B2B content marketing. So it is helpful to look at some of these rankings and see how you're doing. So let's look at some of the opposite, where there is a keyword that is ranking, let's say, 12th, which is pretty good, but why, you know, what's ranking above it? And then what you want to do is look at the videos that are ranking above you and watch them. And just like you would with the SERPs in Google, like you look at a piece of content and say, this is ranking really well, why? And just like with Google, there is a certain level of domain authority with a YouTube video, in the sense that if a video is on a channel with a huge audience, it's more likely to generate views and get those sort of signals that YouTube wants to see for it to rank. But just like with Google, the cream does typically rise to the top. And if you create a great video that is ideal for someone searching for conversion optimization, then it has a good chance of ranking. So what am I specifically looking at? Well, first of all, before I look at the video itself, I'm looking at the topic and I'm seeing, is someone searching for conversion optimization looking for tips? Are they looking for what it is? Are they looking for a combination of both? And in this case, it looks like sort of a mixed bag, but for the most part, the number one result is fundamentals. So that shows to me that people are sort of looking for beginner stuff. And this result here is indicating that people are also looking at how to create their landing pages. So that would be a topic that I would definitely want to cover in my video about conversion optimization, my next video, because the one that's published that isn't ranking well, yeah, there's some stuff you can do with, you know, the description and the title and the thumbnail, but for the most part, you want to use this data really to create your next video and to improve your next video. So I would definitely cover more landing page stuff and less about maybe split testing and things like that. Here's another video that's doing well despite only having a few thousand views, SEO basics and tips for success. So again, that's suggesting to me my conversion optimization video should be on the beginner side. This is an interesting one because this video is a little bit more niche because it's about Shopify. So this is more about optimizing your product and category pages for e-commerce sites. So this is something I would also cover in my conversion optimization video. Even if it was for beginners and not just for e-commerce, I would make sure to throw in an e-commerce example so that I'm matching the search intent here. The last video is about 8 tips for success. So this is more of, you know, actionable stuff that you can do. So once I got this sort of high level and these little checklists of things that I should cover in my video, I would actually watch some of these videos and see the style, the approach, the format. And again, you don't want to reinvent the wheel every time you create a video. That will take too long. You do want to stick to your own format that works for you and fits with your brand. But it's more just getting an idea of people searching for conversion optimization, what do they generally want to see? Do they want to see a case study? Do they want to see something more personal about their someone's journey and how they double their Shopify sales? Or do they want something more general, like here's what CRO is, here's how it works, and here's some tips to get started? And this is going to tell you that. So again, if you're serious about YouTube SEO, just like with Google, tracking your rankings is going to be important. But it's not just about tracking your rankings, it's about learning from your rankings, both those that are doing well and those that aren't doing well, so you can create better video content in the future. So that's how to optimize your YouTube videos using rank tracking. And I'll see you in the next video.